Hare Krishna. Suppose we are in a place where there are known to be invaders. Say the invasion can be by thieves, it can be by enemy soldiers, it can even be natural elements in the form of storms or rivers rising. Now, wherever there is a threat, we always have some defensive arrangement. So there will be some kind of defensive wall. Now, we could say that no wall is foolproof. We might have, say, a wall that defends against winds up to a particular velocity. But a storm might come which is much stronger than that. So, now some people, if some people say that, okay, no matter how big a barrier you make, if a storm comes bigger than that, then what is the use of the barrier? So, yes, the barrier is not foolproof. But if somebody says that, then therefore no barrier is needed. Now, that is utterly foolish, because then any small gust of wind can also cause damage. So, the same applies to us in our spiritual life. See, if we consider our consciousness, that is the territory which we want to protect. And to protect this territory, what do we need? We need the protector, the barrier of consciousness. Barrier. And what is that barrier? That is some kind of regulation, some kind of limitation of access to the sense objects. When we limit the access in such a way, then even if the sensual desires come in, either the temptations cannot come in that easily, or even if they come in, they don't overwhelm us that easily. And in that way, we stay protected. However, some people nowadays say that, yeah, if somebody wants to get tempted, they might get tempted anyway. So, say for example, if you're surfing on the internet and we decide to have some kind of block on the internet for preventing us from misusing the internet. Now, that's good. But that doesn't mean that we can't actually misuse it at all. We can. So, if somebody says there's no need for any barrier, then any casual temptation might come in and that may also overwhelm us. So what we need is barriers. That's why in the Bhagavad-Gītā, Krishna tells us, Tasmat tamindriyanya dau niyamya bharatarshabha papamanam prajahiya enam jnana vijnana nashanam. To regulate the senses. Don't have indiscriminate interaction between the senses and the sense objects. Many times the best way to deal with temptation is to not deal with temptation. So when we, now suppose somebody has a tendency to browse indiscriminately on the net and they put some filter. Now if somebody is a little tech savvy, they can crack the filter also. They can find some loophole across it. That's true. But you know, there are our desires come at different levels. Sometimes when a casual desire comes up, if there's a block, let go. Now if the desire is very wild and intense, then we would go out of our way and find some way out of the block. That's true. But that way, just because the worst storms we can't resist, that doesn't mean we shouldn't try to protect ourselves from the least of storms also. So we do what we can to protect ourselves. And when we do this, when we show by our actions that we want to protect our consciousness, then even if the storms come unbearably, Krishna notes our diligence, our meticulousness, and Krishna will guard us. So, if somebody says no barrier is needed because no barrier is foolproof, then that proof which they are giving indicate that they are a fool. So, let's not be fools and keep our consciousness safe by having barriers in between us and those temptations to which we are most prone. Thank you. Hare Krishna.